Welcome to the April Ballpark Manager Association meeting. I know, let's give us a little bit of applause. That reminds me, we have a birthday tonight. Kim's birthday is today, April 4th. Let's give Kim our round of applause. There's kind of four main agenda items that I want us to talk about today, and then end we'll go into art and now. Okay. So number one is we have a Go-Kart Farmers Market that is coming back this Saturday, April 6th. Gerine Williams is with us here to talk about that. So we're going to get a sneak preview of what's to come with our wonderful neighborhood market. There's also a parks plan that the city of Sacramento is putting together called the 2040 Parks Plan. There's a bunch of handouts over on the table related to that plan. Okay, so we're going to be, OPNA, we want to take a position on this plan. We want to provide input on the plan, so we want to gather you guys' feedback so that we can really do that in a community informed way. Okay? We also have Sam. Sam, can I get back? So Sam Grisham is the executive director of Alchemist. Alchemist is a nonprofit focused on improving access to land and also food access at Minnow Park and around Sacramento. They're the steward and the founder of the Park Farmers Market, or sorry, Oak Park Art Garden. He's going to give us an update on some of the new stuff they're going to be doing at the Art Garden. He came out a few months ago, but there's a big update that some of you guys haven't heard. And lastly, Celebrate Oak Park is happening in Clatchy Park on August 17th. It's OPNA's signature event. We want to kind of, you know, share that info with you and maybe brainstorm a little bit about what we can do for that big event, or we try to bring the community together to celebrate this rich, culturally rich historic community we live in. A lot of park stuff going on today. So with that, we're going to do a quick round of introductions, and then I'm going to hand it over to Gerine.
That's right.
They ain't gonna make it. You know?
thanks for being here. It's so wonderful that we have longstanding neighbors here with us in these meetings, because a lot of us are newer. I've lived here 10 years, and I consider myself a newbie, so thank you for being here.
Or a lot of people ain't working in bars.
That's right. Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? And it was, everybody, they were pranking us that night.
Oh my God, were they?
Oh, you remember.
Do I?
What can I say? But we've made a lot of changes since then.
Yeah.
Look at all that they accepted now. Everything that would be illegal then, everybody's doing it. I mean, I'm not saying it's good or bad, but it's more freedom. You know?
Yeah.
So, I don't know. I feel sad that they're doing a lot of changes for the old people. They're moving all the old ones out. Oh man, when they move the dirt, then they'll move me. But all of the ground.
Well, thank you for being here. We're going to continue through our interest. Thank you.
Okay.
Really appreciate it.
You got to stop us.
Yeah.
And I love Oak Park.
Thank you.
What's the location? Is that the library?
No, is that group, that Sacramento group? You have to see the library.
Okay, come back.
Hi, I'm actually visiting from Curtis Park, I'm from the Sierra Curtis Neighborhood Association. We were wanting to know what's going on with your park presentation today, so I can get some information back over there. This is a beautiful center, I haven't been here before.
Great.
That's wonderful.
This is a big room, there's more room than we need, but there's another meeting happening in our regular spot.
My name's Mark, I'm not a mole from Curtis Park. I live in Oak Park for over a year now, my family and I fall in love with it. On the subject of parks, you often find me and my daughter, who is here a second ago, running back and forth, but has since left to go home, so get them taken. You can find us at the Fourth Avenue Park, which is close to our home, or Patchen Park, so we're a big fan of parks and decided to be more than not the first thing.
Hello, my name is Kelsey, I have been in Sacramento 16 years, for the chicken.
I'm Charles Wheeler, the park owner, I'm in the on set.
There you go.
Good, you have to know.
Say no more. Or my time, sir, clearly.
Hey everyone, I'm Sam Greenley, I'm the Executive Director of Optimus Community Development Corporation, Optimus CDC. We are based here in the neighborhood in Selma Park, and I live on the staff, I've been here for 8 years. And we have multiple gardens and parks in the neighborhood that make my hot dog here.
I'm Jade, I'm also with the Optimus, and I was started as a community gardens coordinator.
Hi, I'm Jamie, the name is Holding, I'm an officer from Jay. I'm the community engagement lead for both the Broadway improvement project that are happening. So I'm here to talk about our workshop coming up at the end of the month. Some key players in here, and so please, I'll be here after the answer to questions as well. But happy to be here to follow up with our presentation in September.
That's important, help inform how Broadway is changing.
It's changing. We need your feedback. It's really good. It's really good.
You'll also do it naturally.
Yes. I will not be going anywhere.
I'm Kim, I'm a board member right now, and I've been on 10th Street for 10 years. I am going to be working on the parks and beautification committee of Park Neighborhood Association. I don't have the information from the area as a board member, and I'll sign up on email. I don't know if that we can get it, we can do that. But that's something I'd like the community to help out with, and maybe for the parks people who want to do some beautification.
I'm not dead. I'm a resident. I'm a block manager.
My name is Sophie. I joined the park from the center for a senior program. I love to be in that, and I love to go to the program.
I'm Sheila Osborne, as you can see, y'all need to talk that much. And I'm from Broadway. I live in Tahoe Park, but I grew up, I started in Oak Park on 2nd Avenue, 3rd and 2nd Corner. And I'm just here for the meeting, like I always do. But you see, I'm out of the phone, not real loud. Now, y'all can do that? My third home is Sacramento. My first home is Broadway, Tahoe Park, Senior Citizen House. And I ain't going nowhere, but I do miss Oak Park. All right.
My
teach this event to pay for people in my own age group. And so I've been doing that for 6 years. Someone else has taken over my classes, so I'm taking a break, but I am here because we kind of form a little group of us who create. We call ourselves Folk Park Garden Mentors. Mm-hmm. And the people in the group have been dying to be have a craft fair somewhere. So we're hoping to be able to be part of your celebration.
Thank you. farmers, it's really early in the season for their products, so they're not ready yet, but they, the market will expand if we get deeper in the summer, and then we'll kind of see if we get them to get farther into the late fall and season.
A little bit of history on that lot. It went up for sale probably
decade ago. A neighbor who nearby purchased it. They were worried about what it would become. They thought it was going to become just something that didn't help the community. So they bought it. They didn't know what to do with it. I played with Alchemist back then. That predates me with Alchemist. But wanting to be put in the community with it. So at that point, Randy Scanner, who probably some of you know, was on our staff. And he now is farming at 364 over in the east end of Tahoe Park. But they did a lot of engagement. I think we tracked down 19 community engagement meetings. Maybe a little more, but didn't have records. But to get input on what was desired for that space. So for years, it was entirely volunteer and donation based on what was happening there. So they planted a fruit tree orchard. A small native garden, has that colorful fence that I think the Sacramento Kings Foundation helped build that fence, and then kids from the school came and painted it. A lot of people have kind of added their own paint to it. The place is meant to be what people said they wanted, was kind of a green space, a little bit of an oasis in the middle of the neighborhood, a place where people could have public art and enjoy public art. So it went along like that for quite a while. There were a lot of issues. We didn't know the space. It was donated to use it. We were using it for free. Didn't know that the owner wanted to sell it to us if we could ever pay off what they had paid for it. Had no utilities. So that beautiful little fruit tree orchard, come summer, it has a really hard time. We can't irrigate it. For a long time, a neighbor nearby let us run the hose, but that house lives there. We very understandably didn't want people using that state all the time. So all kinds of things happened, and it just wasn't a long-term solution. You know, the pathways were mulch, bark, so not even close to ADA compliant, not accessible. So in 2001, we went after a state grant. It was from the Prop 18 grant, if that interesting to you. But we secured money to buy the land and to construct it into what the community had said they wanted from that space. So it's been a really long time. That state grant took like 2 years to even get moving. Costs have gone up and up and up. But we're finally moving on this. We actually will be submitting our entitlement package, that's like a permit package, next week. So that'll be a really big milestone to finally get this moving forward. We have the construction fence up. We had that fence up. Why did we have the fence? We put it up in September online. I've seen people say that fence has been there for 3 or 4 years. I promise you, we went up in September. We have the bill. But we had people dumping there constantly, allowing contractors flipping houses. We're just dumping instead of dumping. So a lot of our volunteer time is going towards trying to keep that out. So we have the fence up there to get it ready for construction, to keep it sort of stable. If you've noticed recently, there are a lot of weeds there. We have a brush mower coming out in the next couple of weeks. We're going to get that knocked down. But the space will be built by next year. So in 2025, it will be done. And if you look at this, you get a sense of what exactly it will entail. So with that grant money, we did buy the land. We are getting the utility connections that we need. And you can see, it's very small, so there's no way to make this PDF. Only not going on very well. But this is kind of a public gathering space. Paved areas, permeable pavement. The city had a lot of requirements about stormwater retention, that sort of thing. So we have a native stormwater pond area that we have a little field. This makes me really see community being able to use for events. I heard that note about going to the craft fair. Like, you know, parking's not great here, but it is a good place. We usually have a public craft fair. Not again, I guess. have Oak Park Soul Community Garden on Broadway. We have the Pansy Park on Pansy Avenue.
Where's the Soul?
It's like right in the middle of the block.
Yeah.
It has painted
several
bricks that
make them are like. Oh, okay. They make them heavy.
Yeah, they're the art made.
Yeah,
that's the art sold art. So this will be a space for like those kind of events or just any other park. It will have a bathroom. That's part of why we have running delays there too. At the bathroom, we open 40 minutes. Unfortunately, we don't have a big budget to deal with having an open plane or anywhere for some reason. But if there's an event there, we open often because it will have programming. Water fountains as well. You know, if you've ever been a pedestrian or cyclist in that area, you know it's a long gap from other drinking fountains. So we're hoping to address that. We have something called the Friendliest Bus Stop. It's already built there. A nice little shaded seating area. Also a little bit of bike repair equipment. Although right before we put the fence up, somebody stole bike repair equipment, so I need to get replaced with the equipment. And then the last couple things you'll note on that are there will be two containers at least, with some shade between them. One of those will eventually have the Oak Park Food Library, so that will be a living library of tools. It'll have some basics, but focus more on the types of tools you need once in your life. So you don't want to go spend $400 on a specialty tool. You borrow that, that's the thing. You pick up the basin wrench. The basin wrench is only 20, but still, you need it once. And then the other container, actually, the Sacramento area bicycle advocate, Saba, will be moving in there with an e-bike library. I believe they're also planning to have a new bike air out of there, free bike air when they open the library. So general rule is both things will probably be open 2 days a week for probably 4 hours. You can come use these libraries and get that help, that sort of thing. But anyway, that was a lot of talking. I'll take a break for any questions, and also if you have questions about Pansy or Oak Park Soul, those are Jane.
Starting over, so we've worked many times with projects. I reached out to Joe last week and today. I didn't mention that you guys have plans to have some different meetings in Rock and Rock coming up. And I just want to know if it's possible that we can do the meeting May 3rd and May 4th with some volunteer help. And typically, we do the Alchemist Garden, Soul Garden, Art Garden. Not so much a Pansy, but the Art Garden and the Soul Garden has like overflow projects. So I just want to see if that's an option. And then you probably already have a schedule with the vendor.
In our staff yesterday, we were talking about a lot. It may or maybe too late. The city has a vacant lot permit, so then we have to clear weeds.
Right.
I can't remember what it is, but.
Okay.
Yes. Well, so basically for the brand, like, we're not hiring a vendor, we're borrowing a brush mower, we have staff, it might be Jane. One of us will be out there.
that site doesn't happen again. That's great.
Garbage in there because it will have the other problem.
have the weeds there right now partly because it's been soft for construction. It's not our, you know, construction will be starting soon, and so we will be knocking down weeds, that sort of thing. But you know, it's also, like, weeded it once, a few months ago, and with the rain, it didn't bounce back that much. But yeah, the dumping, I mean, one thing with dumping that we found in general is a site that looks like it's well-loved and is well-built, but that's where people are less likely to dump. So once it is built, that will need some of that. Part of it's going to be zero tolerance, that we also need neighbors keeping an eye if they see dumping to call 311 right away.
That includes the encampments as well.
Cameras?
Encampments?
There won't be any encampments.
It was just difficult to kind of have like a real volunteer base of labor.
So then I think the next thing we want to talk about is this 24 parts. And does anyone read this? You read it. Has anyone else read it?
I mean,
you're in City Planning Academy. Okay. Anyone else? Raise your hand. Oh, then you skipped it. Okay.
We have people are reading. Look, and I came here.
So this is this Sacramento Parks Plan 24. This is the city of Sacramento's essentially their kind of plan for the next few years. All parts of the city, like priorities. And so there's a few documents. Some folks got the one that I think are going to take the digital survey. This thing's doing
self-policing almost, like people have to, you know, watch out for each other.
So it's, it only works in certain areas, but it's a really nice model because there's absolutely no cost to the city for building it. Like, if you go, I'm going to build a dog park, and they go, okay, you need 6 foot fence, and you need all this stuff. And they're going to do it because it costs a lot of money. But if you find a little area and some hours, I think it works. But people have to pay up, and they have to be like, how many hours do they have to be, you know, and obedience is important.
So what we were told, so Gary with Opart Little League, you know, reached out and said, you know, a lot of concerns again about the dog poo and Little League happening at the same time, off leash dogs, and just chaos.
Right.
And he said that, and he showed me the email that said, this, I think it was the city committing to put up signage saying no off leash dogs, and then committing to have like assigned staff during the meetings. So that was a commitment that the city made, but it has to be has to actually happen, right? So,
yeah.
So I think that's what we would put.
Well, another issue we had that most people here probably don't know is 2 years ago, some children found a new syringe, who are used it as a dart, and thrown it at each other. So, I don't know.
Well, I was going to say.
Well, we got raise hand and then
okay.
Over here again.
This is a personal thing.
Dog parks, I think one of the things we have to do is
job to highway steward for 34th Street. So it's a little funky, a little weedy right now, but we also have an event on April 20th to meet. And that's a native, all native plant garden, no water to the site.
The interpretive sign is done like educational sign stuff. I'm sorry, the theater report back to the city.
Two or three more comments before we're going to go to OPNA. What was Yeah, I will try. First one is I don't see any proposed future park in Oak Park on this map.
Right.
Not in District 5, so that would be the part that I would see here. Second one would be I agree that maintenance is really important, but also I think it's really important that as a neighborhood association, which builds power in the city, we push back on the area that they should be disinvesting parks. Mm-hmm. And we should be picking what kinds of things they should disinvest in. We should tell them, don't disinvest in parks. It's less than a fraction of a percent of the total budget. Maybe they should disinvest in parks. And that would be a more powerful idea. But also in general, I think that there's an opportunity like what Alchemist is doing for a lot of folks that are dealing in like nonprofits, community-based grassroots organizations to be empowered stewards over a lot of the land that the city is collecting. And I work within a grassroots organization that's trying to start community gardens, and it is impossible for the city to start a community garden. You need to have all the funding, all the labor, and everything. And like they would have to pay for water. Or whatever. And so, if they're not going to do it themselves, they need to like fast track that. The more common is how we can do that more power.
Yeah, great.
Can I quickly add something? From somebody who works on a lot of these plans from the community engagement side, this is a really golden opportunity to make your voice known. They don't do these plans often, and this is going to guide our parks for the next 20 to 25 years. Think big. Think of what your kids want. Think about what their priorities should be. They're not going to do another plan like this for 15 or 20 years. And so this is a great opportunity because we have time before Monday to dive into this plan and look at it. As somebody who's served on an engagement team who just did something like this for El Dorado County, they take in your comments and they will hear you. But once this draft plan is set into motion, the time for comments is done. And so please get your comments in. It's really, really important.
So you guys are free, and I encourage you all to use the QR code that you all have. Oh, did you lose yours?
If you don't know how to use QR code, don't stay around and I'll show you.
Thank you. And there might be a URL on there as well. But point being, fill it out. It's better to fill it out than not to fill it out. OPNA is going to work on the letter based on your conversation today. We're going to get that submitted on the 8th. But you all should still submit, your own feedback. Because if that's Oak Park showing up, that's 10, 15, 20 entries. Hey, guess what? It's 3 days before the deadline, but they're all working. They're all coordinating.
You don't care if it comes in 5 minutes before the deadline.
Good. Get it
out. I just want to add, that we should also ask you a hard decision because you still have to invest in
I will say to you, it's kind of all the slides. My kids will get a flash of you like pretty regularly with the play. My kids, and it's getting a little rough, the play with the flooring and stuff. So if it's a 15-year kind of circle back, maintenance would be a big deal, because in 15 years, that's going to be rough.
Well, thank you all for the feedback. Really, I know we have kind of a short timeline on this, and would have been nice to do this meeting earlier in the process, but at least we did. And we're getting ahead of this thing, and it's not reacting, so great work, guys.
Okay, I got one comment.
All right.
Okay, next time we have a meeting here, we need my dog. Oh, we need my dog.
April 23rd over at Salvation Army, 5:30 to 7:30. There will be a short presentation at the start, but if you can't make it till the end, you'll also turn into an open house, so just please stop by if you can. Thank you.
All right. Hands?
Hi, we're here with Girls Rock Sacramento. This is my fellow board member, Yolanda, and we are hosting this summer a Oak Park Girls Rock Camp. So it's from 8 to 17. It's flexible tuition, free of fees. It's really fun. I love the adult camp. You go for a week or a day, you can learn a rock instrument, bass, guitar, singing, keys, examinations, drums. And then they have workshops all week, free lunch, and then at the end, they form a band, they wear a sock, and they perform. And it's really cool, really fun. So if you're at that time, please tell your own girl life. We're going to be hosting it this summer, July 15th, when we make our
journey.
7:17. And I have pamphlets if you want them, and posters if you want them. Come see me.
That's awesome.
Volunteers to help us with it. So we're partnering with Agency on Aging. They're donating all the supplies we need. They're going to have a couple staff members there. But I told them I wouldn't have a problem finding volunteers, so they're not bringing anybody, so it's on us. So we just want people to sign up so we have a good idea of how many people are going. So I have flyers here. There's a bunch more in the front. It's just a QR code. It'll take you to Google Sign In page. If you register that you're going to volunteer, it's April 20th from 9 a.m. to 2 p.m. It'll be a Saturday. And it'll be right here at the center. So I've got a bunch of these flyers, so come find me here at the gravel on the table if you are interested in doing that. And then really quick, back to the parks plans. I have business cards here. I have the link to the digital copy of the entire plan. It's like 200 pages. I'm not picking it out for you, I'm sorry. If you want the link to it, come find me and send me an email and I'll send it to you.
Hello everyone, I'm wearing two hats today as well. So Rock the Block 24 will be taking place here at North Park, May 3rd and May 4th. Our host site is St. Paul Baptist Church. And we are opening up the volunteering to Oak Park residents right now. My community members that live in Oak Park are going to help paint their neighbor's house, build a band fence, mow, hard work for your neighbor, sign up to volunteer. We feed breakfast and lunch. It's a full day. It's fun. You want to volunteer? So great. So we would love to have Oak Park residents come out for that May 3rd, May 4th. The QR code, you just have to take a flyer and scan it. And then, next to community ambassadors in Sacramento, there's a few announcements. We have a foster for the Front Street animal shelter, so we're looking for foster families that are interested in fostering a cat or any pet, and so we're there. The first thing they'll find a home, they'll provide them all the resources and food that we need to take care of the pet. And then second, interested in a job in early childhood education, the city of Sacramento Department will have a program that will get you started if you're interested in child care. So any young people who start up.
Is it a paid thing?
It is an apprenticeship paid on job training. So it's
wow.
Yeah. And then with the summer for the young people who all want to be president one day, the city of Sacramento is offering freshmen, sophomores, juniors the summer at City Hall program. They can kind of learn, civic duties and civic responsibilities and kind of get a, it's kind of like, I guess, to remove government out of high school. So this is a good way to kind of bring it back. And then lastly, Minds Resources Foundation, that is my student from Minds Matter. It's a place for like a therapist for mental health. They are having, well, they're nonprofit, Minds Resource Foundation, they're having a suitcase luggage drive for foster kids. The idea is to strip the, well, to take the plastic bag that the have. They move from house to house, we give them nuggets, they give them out more beans, give them more fried, and their own things they have. So, that will be April 17th at College Hall, where we'll be sending luggage, regular luggage. Our goal is 1,000, but of course, we're going to try to see that. And Tiffany Hatch will also be helping to get the word out. So, we're trying to get her to be here for the last day of the drive at College Hall. So, yeah.
So before we go into other announcements, I'm using OPNA privilege. And this is actually something we chatted with you about a little while ago, Cassandra. I'm doing a debate between the mayoral candidates at the PLP here. Now that we're down to two, that would be something cool to do. In partnership with OPIC Participants Association, all those folks. Would you be down to do that?
Yes.
All right.
Yeah.
Cool. That's something we want to, as we think about planning, you know, let's do that. That's like, you know, a lot of neighborhood groups do those sorts of things.
I think it's a great idea. Fantastic.
Well, we did a District 5 candidate forum.
Yes.
The last go around. So, and then you'll Okay,
I have a whole bunch of announcements about job-related things. So if you are looking for a job, or you're a young person, you know, looking for employment, here's a bunch of stuff. I require all of y'all, so come see me afterwards. First, on Friday, at the Aquatics parking lot in Elk Grove, there's a hands-on job fair for the building trades. If you know somebody who's interested in exploring all the different types of building trades, have them come now. It's great. There's pretty much these days will be there tabling, and then all the union carpenters, electricians, masons, lasers. So, young person looking for a career in building trades, come to the job fair. Second is, yeah, Friday is it. Tomorrow. UC Davis is piloting with La Familia, a workforce training program, to train people for the career that's called sterile processing. These are the people who sterilize surgical instrument trays and get them ready for the next surgery. These are jobs that require training, and usually it's 400 hours of unpaid work experience. But through this program, funded through the City of Sacramento and in partnership with UC Davis and La Familia, those 400 hours of training are paid. So this is an amazing opportunity. They're recruiting three more people for a cohort that starts in May. So there are mandatory information sessions, because as you can imagine, there are a lot of requirements for this particular job and this particular training program. But if you're looking for work, if you know somebody who's looking for work, come get the flyer and go to one of the information sessions next week at La Familia. Okay, next one, UC Davis, the City of Sacramento, and all the job centers are collaborating on a career and resource fair on Friday, April 19th at Fruit Ridge Community Collaborative. There's free lunch, and we would love to see you there. There'll be about 40 employers. There's workshops about interview skills and preparing your application, so really great resources for job seekers. If you are an organization that does youth programming in science, technology, engineering, or math, there are grant funds available through Aggie Square. They're doing 5 grants of $10,000. They've extended the application period, so applications are due next Friday, April 12th. All the information about how to apply is here. We're looking for 5 community organizations. Maybe you can pick this sort of STEM related. 5 grants of $10,000. Straightforward, easy application, and we would love to see more community groups apply for that. I always bring the flyers for Salvation Army and Step Up of their housing safety programs. So if you know somebody who needs some help getting caught up on their utility bills or their rent, or was displaced out of the Oak Park neighborhood and wants to come back, they have programs available that can help residents who are income qualified and City of Sacramento residents. So please come see that. And if you want to get all this stuff in your inbox once a month, sign up for my newsletter. Thank you.
$25 for students, $50 for parents, and it's basically an event to expose high schoolers to different career paths into medicine. So one of the things like people talking about is cleanest and retraining, a lot of different career paths into a medical fields or things that you do as a hospital, not just nurses and doctors, there's a lot of different things. So that's what this symposium is about. We'll have people there talking about financial aid, there'll be interactive workshops and different speakers for the students and parents. So I have flyers on the table, I have more flyers here, and I just thought we had some high schoolers to bring them out to get some information.
So two more announcements.
Two more.
The city of Sacramento has a financial education training program completely free. So they will help you manage your debt, get out of debt, improve your credit, it's completely free. And then also, I know there was some talk about illegal dumping. Right now, the city of Sacramento has a grant for 5,000 that community members, nonprofits can apply for specifically for their children. And that puts it open now. And then one last announcement. The city has a film grant, $10,000 to $15,000 for production or post-production here in the city of Sacramento. They reopened that grant because